In fact, banana is the second most important fruit crop in India next to mango. Its year-round availability, affordability, varietal range, taste, nutritive and medicinal value makes it very favorite fruit among all classes of people. It has also got good export potential. It is consumed in fresh or cooked form, both as ripe and raw fruit. Banana is a rich source of carbohydrate and is also rich in vitamins, particularly vitamin B. It is also a good source of potassium, phosphorus, calcium and magnesium. The fruit is easy to digest, free from fat and cholesterol. Banana powder is used as the first baby food. It helps in reducing risk of heart diseases when used regularly and is recommended for patients suffering from high blood pressure, arthritis, ulcer, gastroenteritis and kidney disorders. Processed products such as chips, banana puree, jam, jelly, juice, wine and halwa can be made from banana fruits. The tender stem which bears the inflorescence is extracted by removing the leaf sheaths of the harvested pseudostem and used as a vegetable. Banana fiber is used to make items like bags, pots and wall hangers. Rope and good quality papers can be also prepared from banana waste. Banana leaves are used as healthy and hygienic eating plates. Therefore, banana is aptly called as Kalpa Vriksha. Now we are going to see the climate and soil factor affecting banana production. Banana is being cultivated throughout the warm tropical regions of the world between 30 degree north and 30 degree south of the equator. Banana, a tropical crop, grows well in temperature range of 15 degree C to 35 degree C with a relative humidity of 75% to 85%. It prefers tropical humid lowlands and is grown from sea level to an elevation of 2000 meter above mean sea level. High velocity of wind, which exceeds 80 km per hour, damages the crop. 4 months of monsoon, that is from June to September, with an average of 650 to 750 millimeter rainfall, are most important for vigorous vegetative growth of the banana. At higher altitudes, banana cultivation is restricted to a few varieties like hill banana. Deep, rich, loamy soils with pH ranging from 6.5 to 7.5 is most preferred for banana cultivation. Now, we will see the banana varieties available in India. Modern edible varieties have evolved from two wild species, namely Musa acuminata and Musa bulbiciana. The Musa paradisica, which was the old name, it is a hybrid between Musa acuminata and Musa bulbiciana. Hence, banana are classified for culinary purpose type as well as the dessert types. Culinary types means they are used for cooking type and are rich in starch and used in the vegetable. Important cultivars are Dwarf Cavendish, Robusta, Mondan, Puvan, Nendran, Red Banana, Nayali, Safed Velchi, Basarai, Andari Puri, Rastali, Karpuravalli, Kartali, Grandine, etc. The dessert types, they are mostly consumed in fruit stage only. The important varieties of this category are Dwarf Cavendish, Robusta, Rastali Puvan, that is Mysore Rasabale, Nendran, Red Banana, Nei Puvan, Virupakchi, Pachanadan, Mondan, Karpuravalli, Safed Velchi and Nanjangud, Elaki, Bala. Now we will see the propagation method. Suckers and tissue culture seedlings are the main planting materials for banana. Sucker is a lateral shoot, or we should aptly call it as a comb, that develops from the rhizome and usually emerge close to the mother plant. The criteria for selection of good suckers are: the orchard or the mother block should be disease free. The weight of the suckers should be 1 to 1.5 kilo. The mother plant should be heavy yielder. Then age of the suckers may range from 3 to 4 months. Then the hole or split of the rhizomes or the combs can be also used when suckers are not available in plenty. Bits of rhizomes may be also used as planting material. Before planting, the suckers are dipped in a solution of 0.5% monocotophos and bevacizumab solutions. Tissue culture plants are clonal materials developed in vitro in the laboratory. They are supposed to be healthy, disease free and uniform in growth and early yielders. Planting and cropping system. Under this, let us see how land is prepared. The land is to be ploughed 2 to 4 times and leveled. Prior to planting banana, green manure crops like danja, cowpea, etc. may be grown and mulched with the soil so that it will increase the nitrogen content as well as the organic matter of the soil. A basal dose of formulated manure, say about 50 tons per hectare before last harrowing, is added and thoroughly mixed into the soil. Planting season. Planting of tissue culture can be done throughout the year as per the market demand, except when the temperature is too low or too high. The planting time may be adjusted so as to avoid high temperature and drought at the time of emergence of bunches, that is approximately 7 to 8 months after planting. The planting time for long duration cultivar is different from short duration ones. The planting distance also is a very important one. In coastal belts where humidity is very high and places where temperature falls down 5 to 7 degrees C, the general spacing is 2.1 meter into 1.5 meter, which can accommodate about 3,174 plants per hectare. In the plains, double line method is followed, with the distance between the two lines is 1.2 meter and the plant to plant distance is 2 meter, which can accommodate around 4,166 plants per hectare. In the fertile soils, with the intensive cultivation practices like high density planting, 3 suckers are normally planted per pit at a spacing of 1.8 into 3.6 meter. This will accommodate about 4,600 plants per hectare, which is suitable for Cavendish varieties. In the case of Nendran, the spacing is 2 into 3 meter, which can accommodate 5,000 plants per hectare. Now we will see what are the aftercare requirement of banana cultivation. During the life cycle, the plant produces 30 to 40 leaves at the rate of 4 leaves per month depending on variety. The last leaf produced at shooting, which is small in size, is called the flag leaf. The first distinguishing feature between vegetative and reproductive phase is the production of bract primordium. The basal, that is proximal nodes of the inflorescence, bears female. The upper one, or there is a distal nodes, contain the male flowers. In between the male and female flowers, the hermaphrodite flowers, it is called the neutral flowers, which have stunt ovaries and do not develop into edible fruits. Banana is botanically called a berry fruit. The edible bananas are vegetative parthenocarpic. The female sterility gene and lack of pollen due to triploidy nature causes seedlessness in banana. While the pollination is essential for fruit development in the wild seeded bananas, it is not required for cultivated bananas. Next, we will see how water, nutrient and weed management affect the production. Banana being a succulent crop, evergreen and shallow rooted, it requires large quantity of about 1800 to 2000 millimeter per annum of water for increasing productivity. In winter, irrigation is provided at an interval of 7 to 8 days, while in summer, it should be given at an interval of 4 to 5 days. However, During rainy season, irrigation is provided only if required. Excess irrigation will lead to root zone congestion due to the removal of air from the soil pores, thereby affecting plant establishment growth. In all, about 70 to 75 irrigations are provided to the crop. Drip irrigation is a very important technique for banana production. Application of irrigation through drip system helps to maintain the proportion of soil, air and soil water, which results in early and vigorous growth of the bunches. Raw bunch gets early maturity by about 30 to 45 days and the yield is increased by 15 to 30%, and there is a saving of water by 58 to 60%. Weed management cost is reduced and all the other intercultural corporations are also saved. Drip irrigation may be given at 15 liters per plant per day from planting to 4th month, then slowly increase to 20 liters per plant per day from 5th month till shooting stage, and afterwards about 25 liters per plant per day from shooting till 15 days prior to harvest. Fertilizers. About 100 gram of nitrogen per plant as top dressing in 3 equal split doses, 60, 90 and 120 days after planting. Further application of 100 gram of potash and also 40 gram of phosphorus are applied at planting. Potassium is indispensable in banana cultivation due to its role in vital functions. It is not stored and its availability is influenced by temperature. Thus, continuous supply is required at finger filling stage. Application of potash 100 gram in 2 splits during vegetative phase and 100 gram in 2 splits during reproductive phase is recommended. Application of 200 to 300 grams of potassium oxide K2O is recommended depending upon the cultivar. Muriata potash is generally used as a source of potash, but in soils with pH above 7.5, potassium sulfate is advantageous. Fertigation. In order to avoid loss of nutrients from conventional fertilizers, that is loss of N through leaching, volatilization, evaporation and loss of P and K by fixation in the soil, application of water soluble or liquid fertilizers through drip irrigation, which is called fertigation, is adopted. A 25 to 30% increase in yield is observed using fertigation. Moreover, it saves labor, time and the distribution of nutrients is very uniform. Weed management. Spraying of glyphosate before planting at 2 liters per hectare is carried out to keep the plantation weed free. 4 to 5 weedings are to be done whenever necessary. Harrowing the field 3 to 4 times to keep the soil loose. Earthing up should be done 3 to 4 months after planting, raising the soil level around the base of the plant by 10 to 12 inches. It is better to prepare a raised bed and keep the drip line on bed 2 to 3 inches away from the plant. It also helps to protect the plants from wind damage and production losses to some extent. Next, we will see the special horticultural techniques for banana production. One is desuckering. It is the removal of unwanted suckers, which is the critical operation in banana for reducing the internal competition with the main plant. Small suckers are removed on regular basis up to 7 to 8 months. Next is the propping. Due to heavy weight of the bunch, the plant goes out of balance and the bearing plant may lodge, and production and quality are adversely affected. Therefore, they should be propped with the help of two bamboos forming a triangle by placing them against the stems on leaning side. This also helps in uniform development of the bunch. Next is the bunch cover and spray. The covering the bunches using dried leaves of the plant is economical and prevents bunch from direct exposure to sun and also enhances the quality of the fruit. But in rainy season, this practice should be avoided. Sleeving of the bunch is done to protect the fruits against dust, spray residue, insect and birds. Transparent and perforated polythene sheets with 2% during the cool season, 4% vent during summer season may help to reduce the incidence of the diseases, pests, etc. This may be combined with neem application, say 1 kg per hectare. It increases the temperature around the developing bunch and also helps in early maturity. Spraying of monocotophos at the rate of 0.2% concentration after emergence of all hand is effective in controlling the thrips, which usually affects the developing fruits. Thrips attack discolors the fruit skin and makes it unattractive. Next is the dehandling of false hands of the bunch. Some incomplete hands in a bunch which are not fit for quality produce should be removed soon after bloom. This helps in improving the weight of the other hands, finger size and improved skin pulp ratio to meet the export standard. Mulching. Use of wheat straw and banana straw as mulch material, say at the rate of 12.5 kg per plant in banana, is helpful to increase the bunch weight and conserve the soil moisture. The mulch is applied at the beginning of summer months, February to March, etc. Intercropping. The root system of banana is superficial and gets easily damaged by cultivation. Therefore, use of intercrop is not desirable. However, short duration crops, say which will complete in 45 to 60 days, like mung bean, cowpea, danja, are to be considered as green manure crops. Leguminous crops, beetroot, elephant foot yam, ginger, turmeric, sunnab may be also grown as intercrop during the first 3 months. However, growing of cucurbitaceous vegetables should be discouraged as they are having viral infection source. In coastal regions of Karnataka, Kerala and Andhra Pradesh, banana is grown in coconut and arecanut plantations with tall cultivars. Now, we will see the other farm operations related to banana production. One is the removal of dry leaves, that is green leaves should not be removed. During the winter months, if temperature goes below 10 degrees C, growth of the plant is affected. Under such circumstances, irrigation is to be provided at night or smoking is to be done by inducing fire. If neem cake at the rate of 1 kg per plant is applied during winter months, the formation of bunch becomes easier. Plantation should be protected from strong winds by growing tall plants along the farm border. We will now see the plant growth regulation in banana. In order to improve the grade of bunches, 2,4-D at 25 ppm, that is 25 mg dissolved in 1 litre of water, may be sprayed after the last hand has just opened. Besides, spraying of CCC 1000 ppm at 4th and 6th month after planting and plantosime at the rate of 2 ml per litre at 6th and 8th month after planting also helps to achieve higher yield in banana. After the full development of bunches, potassium trihydrogen phosphate 0.5% and urea 1% or 2,4-D solution at 10 ppm is sprayed on the banana so that bunch size and quality are improved. The process of flowering governed by gibberellins like substances helps in development of plant. Later on, anthocyanin hormone inducing flowering of plants, both combiningly called as dual factors hypothesis. Spraying of NAA at 100 ppm after 5 to 7 months of planting markedly increase the fruit size and yield. Application of GA3 at 50 mg per litre results in maximum yield and required lesser number of days for fruit maturity, especially in giant governor variety of banana. Now we will see the important diseases and disorders. First is the important pest attacking banana. Pseudostem borer is a very important pest. The symptom is the exudation of plant sap in the initial symptom and blackened mass comes out from the holes bored by the larvae. Rhizome weevil is another important pest which is very common in Nendran. They damage the combs by feeding the tunnels which will filled with masses of rotten tissues. Banana aphid. It is a vector of many virus diseases, especially bungee top disease. Then fruit and leaf scoring beetle. The beetle feeds on young leaves and skin of young fruits. Occurrence is maximum in rainy season. Now we will see the various diseases affecting banana production. Panama wilt. This is caused by the fungus Fusarium oxysporum. It is the most severe and important diseases of banana. Rustali is highly susceptible to this particular disease. Robusta and Dwarf Cavendish are the resistant varieties available now. Leaf spot or Sigatoka. It is a fungal disease initially presence of light yellowish spots on the leaves under severe conditions, formation of brown spots, and later dies turning light green surrounded by brown ring. Bungeetop virus, it is called BBTV. It is transmitted by the aphid, which is the vector called Petalonia nigra nervosa. Dwarf banana cultivars are very susceptible. The leaves are bunched together like a rosette at the top. Margins are wavy and slightly rolled upward. Dark green streaks of the lamina and midrib could be also seen. The plants are stunted and do not produce bunch of the commercial cultivar if infected at very early stage. Other diseases affecting banana are pseudostem heart rot, diamond spot, anthracnose, cigar end tip, count rot, bacterial soft rot, bacterial wilt or moco disease, banana streak virus and banana bract mosaic virus. Now we will see the maturity indices and harvest requirement for banana. Banana is harvested when the fruit is slightly or fully mature depending on the market preferences. For long distance transportation, harvesting is done at 75% to 80% maturity. The fruit is climacteric and can reach consumption stage only after ripening operation. The planted crop gets ready for harvest within 12 to 15 months of planting, and the main harvesting season of the banana is from September to April. Bunches attain maturity from 95 to 150 days after flowering, depending upon the variety, soil, weather conditions and the elevation. Bunches should be harvested when fingers of second hand from the top are 3/4 rounded with the help of sharp sickle 30 cm above the first hand. Harvest may be delayed up to 100 to 110 days after opening of the first hand. Harvested bunch should generally be collected in well padded tray or basket and brought to the collection site. Bunches should be kept out of light after harvest since this hastens ripening and softening. For local consumption, hands are often left on stalks and sold to retailers. The dwarf varieties are ready for harvesting within 11 to 14 months after planting, while tall varieties take 14 to 16 months. After harvest of bunches, only leaves are to be cut and plant system is retained for return crop development. This improves the food supply and about 15% can be saved on irrigation. For getting good quality fruit, only 7 to 8 berries are to be retained in a bunch. First return crop would be ready by 8 to 10 months from the harvesting of main crop, and the second return by 8 to 9 months after the second crop. Thus, over a period of 28 to 30 months, it is possible to harvest 3 crops, that is one main crop and 2 return crops. The yield of banana depends on a number of factors such as variety, plant density and management practices. Now we will see the post harvest management practices. Grading. Grading is mainly based on size, color and maturity of the fruits. While grading, smaller fruits are separated from the large ones in order to achieve uniform ripening. Immature, overripe, damaged and diseased fruits are discarded in the process of grading. Fruits are generally harvested early in the season at a premature stage to capture early market. Ethylene application is the best method to hasten ripening without loss to fruit quality and flavor. Mature fruits are ripened with lower doses of ethyl for uniform color development, that is slow ripening under controlled conditions at 15 degree to 80 degrees C. Mature green bananas can be stored for about 3 weeks in ethylene free air or up to 6 weeks in a controlled atmosphere at 14 degrees C. Packing. Wooden or cardboard boxes, rectangular in shape and bamboo baskets are used normally for packaging and transportation of fruits. In some cases, banana bunches are packed in old gunny bags wrapped with banana leaves. Packing of hands or dehandled fruits in polythene, about 100 kg polythene bags with 0.2% holes, enhance the shelf life under room temperature as well as in cold storage. While polythene bags without perforations develop fungal infection due to high humidity. High quality bananas are generally exported. Firstly, fingers are removed from the bunch and washed in water. Then they are washed in dilute sodium hypochlorite solutions to remove the latex and dipped in 0.1% carbetazim solution. And finally, air dried. These fingers are graded on the basis of their length, girth and packed in plastic corrugated fiber board, that is CFB boxes, cartons, having a capacity of about 13 to 14.5 kg. A suitable packaging material like foam may be used. These boxes are kept at 13 to 15 degrees C temperature and 80 to 90% humidity, having cold storage. Banana can be stored in such controlled atmosphere in a cooling chamber for a period of 20 to 25 days. The bananas are to be exported via cold chain of shipment at 30 degrees C and refrigerated vans. Regarding transportation, they are transported by trucks or lorries, which is the most popular mode of transport due to easy approach from the orchards to the market. For long distance markets, rail wagons are used. Regarding marketing, several intermediaries like wholesalers and commission agents are involved in marketing of the fruit. Private traders carry out nearly 95% of the trade and even provide credit to farmers for cultivation, but at high rate of interest. Cooperative account about 5% of the balance of the trade volume. Banana can be stored at about 30 degrees C with a rate humidity of 85 to 90% for 3 weeks and is ripened in a week at 16 to 21 degrees C. Fruit should not be stored or shifted under refrigerated conditions. Storage life can be increased by keeping the fruits in high concentration of carbon dioxide and low concentration of oxygen. Storing can be done in sealed polythene packs containing ethylene absorbents like potassium permanganate. Then shrink film wrapping or Vexal 12% treatment can extend the life of the fruits by 3 weeks. Banana are not usually allowed to ripen on the tree. Smoking have to be done with straw leaves and cow dung in a closed chamber for 18 to 24 hours in summer and 48 hours in winter, then later shift to ventilated rooms for uniform ripening. The exogenous application of 100 ppm of ethylene gas in an enclosed chamber for 24 hours will produce uniform color and ripening. Now we will see the summary of banana, what we have learned. Say, banana is the most important and is the second important crop in India next to mango. It is year-round production, affordability and varietal range, taste, nutritive and medicinal value makes it more important and favorable fruit among the all classes of people. Modern edible varieties are believed to have developed from two wild species, namely Musa acuminata and Musa bulbiciana. Over a period of 20 to 30 months, it is possible to harvest three crops, that is one main crop and two return crop. The common insect pests observed are the rhizome weevil, stem borer, banana thrips, banana beetle, banana aphid, and the diseases are barama wilt, anthracnose, leaf spot, etc. The planted crop gets ready for harvest within 12 to 15 months of planting, while main harvesting season of the banana is from September to April. Bunches attain maturity within 90 to 150 days after flowering. Mature green fruits can be stored up to 3 weeks in ethylene free air or up to 6 weeks in controlled atmosphere at 14 degrees C. The exogenous application of 100 ppm of ethylene gas in an enclosed chamber for 24 hours will produce uniform color and ripening.